Hello there. So I ended up taking Inigo with us anyway. Because A, why not? B, the carts are bugging out. And I guess we're just gonna have to run there, so I'm gonna need all the help I can get. Let's go. It's late, but you know what? I do not even care. This has to be taken care of. We have a long road ahead of us. There's no need to complain about anything. Let's map out a route of some kind. Let's see, we have to go here. We have to go here. This Driftshade Refuge is where we're headed. Whoops. Yep, right over here, so, I guess we could fast travel to Loria's farm, and we're gonna do that now, because what fun is it to see places we've already seen? Just imagine us walking peacefully, having a nice casual chit chat, people joking around, a couple of wolves die, and hey, that creepy old character's gone from there. I guess he got his wagon wick fixed. Good for him. Good for him. So we're just gonna carry on here. This way. Gonna have to enter into the darker areas here soon. What time is it? We know what? No. Ha, there's a wolf. Now, can't that wolf just kind of wander off and run away from us? Isn't this how animals really behave in nature unless they're completely feral and... Yeah, this one's... See? This one doesn't care. It's just gonna go away. The other one, though. Let's see. Yeah, look, it's a peaceful wolf. These, though. Ha! I see you, and you see me.
Did you hear something?
Well, I think.
It did go well, however. What are y'all screaming
We're going
about?
to make them pay. Until next time.
I apologize. I didn't mean to address you at this point. Oh, I don't even have face light on. Hello. How about you guys? I think face light is a really good little see edit mode. Okay, now let's exit. E. E. And see how it's done now. See, we got Vilkas, we got Inigo. Both of them have a dark face light. And it's all because look at us, we're so awesome. All of us, all three of us. We need to have that divine glow going on. Oops, I forgot to, There we go. All right, let's get crack-a-lackin'. We have a long road ahead of us. Lots of bad guys. There's that poor settlement of those poor old men, all alone with their mammoths. Kinda makes me sad, you know? Nobody to hang out with, except the mammoths. Ooh, it's getting cold. And instant winter. That would be so cool. You know, there's an area where there's always winter. If you want to play with snow, you can go over there. Okay, so we're heading straight. And then, you know what? This is not too far away now. I am kind of surprised. Usually, when you go to Dawnstar, when you take a carriage to Dawnstar, and you still have to run quite a ways down south and then make a left and go up a hill and all kinds of issues start happening, but this is not bad. What is this? Another one of those wandering afflicted? Oh, he's going the other way. Don't have to worry about him. Let's see, Dawnstar is this way, and we are also headed that way. Then at one point, we're gonna make a right and go up the hill. Okay, yeah. Need a coat, need a winter coat. It's getting cold. Too much weather, my god. My FPS is dropping in this location. Uh-oh. Oh my god, no. Are you just gonna stare? Hell. Yeah, I'm sure that was quite interesting. It's like, oh, what is that? Look at that. It's a giant bear with a septum and some strange venom. Do you guys not get along very well? Well, get used to it. This is the first little intersection here that we're not gonna take. Have to go a little bit. Don't tell me there's another one. What, right behind you?
Things considered.
Yeah, I think it did. It went okay. What you got? Just some venom. It went alright. It went pretty good. Oh, what was this place here? I guess we're gonna find out once we get closer. Let's see here. Oh, I'm still going the right way. I think we have to go around. Really don't feel like aggravating this guy's in here. They're hell-bent on protecting their little broken old place. Yep, just nothing to see here. Just a dragonborn and a couple of helpers. Fort Dunstadt. Dunstadt? See, I think they were pretty peaceful. Morning is coming up too. The sky looks gorgeous. Oh, loud. I'm going Lord knows where. I gotta make a right. Go past this place here. Get back on the road. See, I almost have a good mind to just walk every single path in Skyrim. Walk them slowly. Look at everything, remember everything. Just kind of make a mental map. Then I won't ever have to really guess where I'm at. I'll know exactly where I'm at. It's always a good feeling to know exactly where you're at. What's around the corner? What kind of help you can possibly expect? Like maybe like an inn or a... What did you find? Oh, my goodness. I'm sorry, I was a bit late helping you out. Is this it? Is this where we have to go? That is it. And then we're gonna have to go up a hill and past this old... I wonder how old it is. It looks like it's 1,000 years. More than that. Fort Fellhammer. Nobody is taking care of it. They've just built some wooden things on top. Taken down some trees. That is a giant tree they chopped down. My god. Imagine the thud that happened when this thing fell. Whew. Okay, we're almost there. See, that wasn't too bad. I was all concerned that what am I gonna do now? My carriages aren't working and... I don't know what's going on, if it's the issue of being over-encumbered, which shouldn't really happen. Because I'm not over-encumbered here, I am running. If I have too many followers, too few followers. Oops, I just took a wrong little path. Y'all can follow, it's alright. Aha, you know what, I think we're here. I think we're here. So, think this is a good time to arrive, because not many people are going to be up at this hour. They're either just falling asleep, too tired. See? This one just went to sleep. Seriously, I wish my computer would make up its mind about FPS. Sometimes I have like 126, and now it's like 34. Why? Why is this going on? Inigo, I hope you can enter. Where did Vilkas go? Where you at? Come on. Okay, Driftshade Refuge. I wonder, I think... Wasn't it... There's this one time I was playing it, and in some locations it says your follower cannot accompany you in here. However, hey, here we are. I think we're gonna do all right. I kind of feel bad making Vilkas sneak. But, I'm a sneaky person, so... That's just what's gonna happen. Inigo's rolling. Alright, there's some people there. Walking back and forth. I wonder if this is the morning patrol or if they're waiting for breakfast. Oh my goodness, that was pitiful! What was that? What could it have been?
Thought I heard something.
Hit her!
The fool lets himself get surrounded.
She was not surrounded. She was this way, and we were this way. There was nobody behind her. Good looking at me. Where'd she go? Oh, there's him. You got some money? I'll take your money. Alright, so we're gonna have to go this way. There's some books here.
Books. These silver hands deserve every ounce of pain we bring them, my friend.
Every ounce indeed. Galerion the Mystic. We should take it and read it one day.
Time to finish this!
Oh my god!
My patience.
That's how a true Nord fights.
Indeed. They are pretty independently wealthy over here, these people. What you got there? Pearl, garlic, and fire salts. I can probably use that pearl to make something. I wonder if I have better weapons. Just tired of this. I'll do the eviscerators.
Idiotic werewolf hunters. Dedicating your life to hating others is shameful.
Inigo, thank you for that. That is very, very, very well said. This goes for everybody. Just pay attention to what Inigo is saying. They are pretty idiotic. Anything interesting over here? Well, well, well. Hello. Some light reading. What is this? It doesn't look very burned. Looks like I could still make out what the words are. Anything else? Everything else is burned. I'll let you borrow that book that I just found later, if you want. Anybody else? Anybody else coming to meet us? Who is here? Let's see, a door? One thing about this place is that there aren't too many loading screens. It's like...
Never should have come here.
Found us, my friend.
And I thank you.
Bad
idea. Help!
Another day, another victory.
Yeah, see, if you have all kinds of help, then you don't have to worry. It's got an ebony arrow and 109 septims. My goodness. Were you planning on making an expensive purchase of something, or where'd you get all that money? Copper diadem. You know, I'm sure it's very pretty. He probably had saved that money for a long time and was planning on buying a new set of pretty boots or something like that. Song of Pelennor. Yeah, I'm gonna have to start saving up books because my library at the house is pretty, Oh, uncommon taste. Yes. My library at the house is pretty empty. Oops, I'm sorry, I had to scratch my face. Bumping into the microphone like that is quite rude. The Wisp Mother, I will take. Minor Stamina, Explorer's Guide to Skyrim. That may actually, yeah, see, map updated, so. Charwich Koenig Letters. I sometimes wonder what's the difference between some of those books don't cost a lot of money at all, and then some of them, of course, the ones that are skill books are expensive, but then some of these, like these, they're 12 versus just being a couple of gold. Is there any benefit to them, or? Okay, let's run. Dragging my feet over here. My god, FBS, what is the matter with you? Is there like a background thing going on, or a forge? You see, this is 14, so it's, Oh look, a chest. It's probably the light. Stamina. Hysteria. I should try casting that Hysteria scroll later on when we get to the last room. See what happens with it. Oop. I wonder what is... Okay, I think there's somebody sleeping in this room, so... I'm going to... open it and just good night. What you got here? You got anything good? Looks like you got all kinds of stuff. Look at this mess in this house. Seriously, this is room. Is this how you sleep? Do you not feel like just a little bit uncomfortable? Sleeping in a room with this mess, like, you just start feeling uneasy, unless you're super tired. Honestly, I wouldn't fall asleep in a room like that. Anything here? No? Oops. Nope. This poor person. Forever sleeping in this bed. Alright. Putting that light away, tired of all this flickering and twitching. Just in case. Let's see here. What's around the corner? Anybody interesting? Oh, it's this room. Alright guys, be ready. I'm sure there's somebody around the corner here. You?
Look out!
What was that?
Oops. What are you guys doing? Jesus Christ, help me, help me, help me, help me!
That's your best, huh? Let's see what you've got!
Show him!
You need a few more arrows in you. Yes, dismissed.
Huh, thank you. This is what I'm best at. Saying thank you to the guys who kill bad guys for me, so thank you. Thank you. Emerald Ariella, so pretty. I won't wear it though. Oh, here's another little room. Did I ever look in here? I think this is the food room. Yeah, it's the food room. Nothing really interesting here unless I'm super hungry, which I'm not. What you got here? Well, that's all I'm gonna take is just the septums. Now I think we have a loading screen. Okay. I think there's some bad guys around these corners. Now who builds these places with all these nooks and crannies? Ooh. Eh. Nah. There's a dime a dozen. Everywhere. If I really wanted to get some gold, then I could melt down some septims.
Is someone there?
What's that?
Hit her! You know what? I'm just gonna start walking into the room and saying, okay boys, take it away. Vampire? Oh, was she a vampire? Were you a vampire? I don't think so. Would have noticed something.
This expedition saddens and enrages me in equal measure.
You're right. All the stuff that we have to do, constant bickering and bitching and griping and complaining. Just imagine what life would be like if everybody was friendly. Just think about that for just 1 second. And I'm not just saying Skyrim. I'm saying everybody, like everywhere. Imagine how much money we would save, like just not spending it on fighting constantly. Oof. Everybody would be so happy. What's here? Anything interesting? No. The sword. Oh!
Thought I heard something.
I'll try and make you sweat.
Dang!
I did not know for messing with.
Indeed. Seriously, if you see a door open and then our crew walks in, just put down your weapons
over
and decide
here.
That it's over. Oops, sorry.
You're a disgrace to your own kind. Sneer. You're paid for that.
Well, help out then a little bit. Just over here standing on your.
Something?
You die like the rest when you mess with the best.
Well, we didn't really do nothing, guys, seriously. Y'all were just standing there, taking it. I can imagine, you know, an incredibly powerful tank and a strong DPS. But here I am, just a fumbling fool. I'm gonna try to help out a little bit. The rear guard. What a promiscuous name for a book. Do we have to go? Where do we have to go? This way? Okay, just in case I'm gonna. There may be some creatures here that we don't really want to deal with. Well, any trolls? Anybody who wants to battle us? No? I'm not gonna go up there. Probably just some. Poor, pitiful werewolf near their death. This time you should help out.
Mercy.
There is
well,
no mercy.
All things considered.
Yes, since they keep hitting me for some reason, and now it's raining. I don't have enough room for this. I'd like to, but there's only this much pelt that we can carry. Ugh. Only this much pelt that we can carry with us. Is this the last end? No? Yes? No? No, not oh, this is the big room still. That's quite a large room. However, I have given up on commentary on these kind of stupid questions.
That it? That your best?
Y'all are funny. What does she have? Oh, she was a silversmith, huh? Hello. I think there's some stuff back there behind the fireplace, but I don't feel like going. Pardon me, ma'am. Don't feel like... Shouldn't be looking up your skirt. Oh, carrying too much. Septims Inigo.
I am here for you.
Can you take some stuff,
please? I hope
please?
This will be a mutually beneficial exchange.
It always is. What do you think? Let's see. Take this one. Take this one. Take one of these. Yeah. I think we're good for now. Mm-hmm. Thank
okay.
you.
Okay. Let's do it.
Okay, what is this it? Wait a minute, I don't remember. Is this the last room? Oh, no, it's another loading screen. Ooh. Shows how much I remember. Ran through here so many countless times and still don't remember every single little detail. Oh, I think this is it, yes. This is the refuge. Alright, guys. Be ready, Inigo, especially you. Oh gods, don't tell me you're stuck. Thank god. Alright, this is gonna be a room full of bad people. And they're all really bad. I'm sure they don't hear me, they especially don't hear Inigo coming. But Vilkas with his giant outfit. Oh my goodness, I can't even. Oh. Huh? Hello, let me alert you to the fact that we're entering the room. Damn.
That's your best.
I'm just gonna watch. Oh no, oh no. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Do I have any? I hope I have some extra magicka.
Hey, they are done. Let us move on.
Oh, it's Inigo. So, are you just like, what? What just happened? What just transpired? Take the. I did not want to sit here every time. Ah. Yes? Let me just look around a little bit. What do you have? Tons of steptons. Ebony arrow, I will take
we
it.
We have what we came for. I need some fresh air, I think.
Are you okay?
Let's get back to Yorvaskar. We'll want to pay our respects to Kodlak's spirit.
In a minute.
All right.
Hawk feathers are always good. What does this guy have here? Cure disease. He's a reader, so not too bad. Iron arrow. What else do we have? Lots of interesting literature here. Warrior. Good, good, good. We need everything. We need everything we can get. The Code of Malakath. That's probably what the orc was reading. And another Song of Pelennor. One that I have not seen yet. Oh, I think there's a chest as well. Is there anything interesting here? Bebony, oh! I will take it. I'm gonna have to start using it. That Bebony O. Alright, let's go, let's head out of here. Let's go to Yorvaskar. Attend the funeral. It's only fair. Oh. Well, that went well. A lot better than that fiasco with Ayla. Goodness gracious, I'm still embarrassed about that. Whoa! Alright, you guys, let's go. Return to Yorvasker, if this thing would work. What is this? What is going on here? Hello?
Someone we have someone wanted attention.
I am doing something.
Textbook example of skill and grace.
So let me ask you this. If you say someone do something, why won't you elaborate? I am doing something. I'm standing. That's doing something. I'm waving my hands around in the air. That's also doing something. Someone do something is not a very accurate description of what it is that you want done. Oh, what is in this? Barrels. It's nothing. Nothing. This one has... Ooh, salt. Always comes in handy. Okay, see, we wouldn't have been able to even go anywhere with that guy standing over there if we wouldn't have noticed. Would have been like, why can't we fast travel? There's an enemy nearby and he's hiding there halfway into the wall. Some people just have no manners.
The others have probably prepared Kodlak's funeral by now. Come up to the Sky Forge to pay your respects.
All right, let's go. Let's go, Inigo. Let's pay our respects. This is a daytime funeral. I have to say that a nighttime funeral is much prettier because everybody has those lights and so forth. But hey, I'm not going to complain. A person has passed away. They lived an honorable life. And you guys better not be out there banging on that smelter while we're having a funeral, because seriously, that would just be so rude.
Who will start?
We're not here yet. Wait.
Before the ancient flame.
We grieve. At this loss.
We weep.
Position ourselves properly. Inigo, you here? Okay.
For the fallen.
We shout.
See, it's going a little bit backwards.
And for ourselves.
She keeps stretching her neck like...
We take our leave.
Whoa.
His spirit is departed. Members of the Circle, let us withdraw to the Underforge to grieve our last together.
Let's go.
Do you have the fragments of Uthrad still?
Yes.
I'll need to prepare them for mounting again.
Here.
Careful with those. Don't want even more fragments, do we? Of course, I have a small favor to ask of you. There's another piece that Kodlak always kept close to himself. Would you go to his chambers and bring it back for me?
Sure.
I'm not sure I'm the best one to go through his things. Thank you. I'll be here.
Thank you for just saying, like, thank you and not getting all smart and uppity with me.
A sad day. Kodlak was a good man.
He sure was. A peaceful man. A man of honor. We'll go get the fragments and nose up into his journal, because I know we're supposed to find out what a great person I am, even though I haven't really done much nothing while with the companions, and there's bunches of people here who have done so much more. Let's go in and go see what we find here. I think this here is quite a nice little living arrangement, though. Not too big, not too small. No windows, though. Oh, it's got one of these things. I will take it. Yes. All right. Fragment. Journal. These are his septims. I'm not going to take his septims. They're not quite mine yet. Journal Kodlax. Okay, so in my dream, I see the line of harbingers start with Iskramor. Each of them ascends to Sovngarde until we come to Turfig, who first turned us to the ways of the beast. He tries to enter Sovngarde, but before he can even approach Tsun, he is set upon by a great wolf who pulls him into the hunting grounds, where Hirsine laughs with welcoming arms. Turfug seems regretful, but also eager to join Hirsine after a lifetime of service as a beast. Then I see every next harbinger turn away from Sovngarde and enter the hunting grounds of their own accord, until it comes to me, and I see Great Tsun on the misty horizon, beckoning me. It appears I have a choice, and then, at my side, a stranger I had not seen before. As I look into her eyes, we turn to see the same wolf who dragged away Turfug, and she and I draw weapons together. I realize this is only a dream, but a strong enough dream to inspire a man like me to take to writing, so it must be of some import. I've spoken of my thoughts to the Circle, withholding the part about the stranger, lest Skjor worry I will no longer seek his counsel, and I was not surprised to see them torn by it. Skjor and Aela are strong in the ways of the beast, and even seem to suggest that the hunting grounds would be their choice of afterlife, if it were truly a choice. Vilkas seemed most troubled. The boy is as fierce as a saber cat in battle, but his heart's fire burns too brightly at times. He felt deceived, and I don't blame him. Farkas didn't know what to think, but I believe he will come around with me and his brother eventually. He usually does. I don't know what to do about Skjor and Aela. I know they respect the companions and me, but they take to the blood more deeply than the rest of us. Fortune smiles upon us. Yesterday, Vilkas was telling me how difficult it had been for him to give up his transformations. Until we can pursue a true cure, the twins and I have chosen not to give in to the beast blood. For me, it's provided a clearer head, but Vilkas seems to be suffering a bit for it. Farkas seems completely untroubled. That boy continues to amaze with his fortitude. While Vilkas was confiding through the shadows of Jorvaskr, I saw a newcomer approach, who wished to join our numbers. It was the stranger from my dream, the one who would stand with me against the beast. Vilkas began speaking obliquely, not wishing to air our problems out in front of our guest, and I had to be doubly cautious to not reveal anything of our secrets to the newcomer, while also not revealing the details of my dream to Vilkas. I don't know how the politicians deal with these sorts of machinations daily. In any case, I've sent Vilkas to test the newcomer. We'll see if she is truly the great warrior I dreamt of. This newcomer, it seems, is made of decent stock. She calls herself Wolf the Gentle, and has already impressed some of the Circle with her mettle. I still keep my own consul on her place in my dream, for now. Let us see what kind of destiny she is carving before hitching to her. In the meanwhile, I look for ways of cleansing my blood. The writings and legends on the subject are sparse and contradictory. I don't wish to engage any wizardry on this matter, but I fear they may be the only ones who best know how to navigate these worlds of knowledge. It's apparent to me now that Turfig's choice to turn us was indeed a mistake. Magics and their ilk are not in keeping with the spirit of the companions. We face our problems directly, without the needs of such trickery. I can only hope to guide us back to the true path of Iskramor before the rot takes me. Wolf the Gentle continues to impress. I don't know yet where she will stand on the question of the blood, but the question has not been presented yet. She does not know that we carry the beast blood, and appears curious about it. Soon enough, I can explain our troubles, and hopefully see what role she will play. I'm amazed that Aela thinks she can keep a secret among this drunken rabble. Especially with the loss of Skjor, my heart aches. Emotions are fraying, and the walls of discretion are the first to fall. Apparently she and Wolf the Gentle are waging their own separate war against the Silver Hand, in retaliation for Skjor's death. their hearts are noble, but the course of vengeance is running hot, and I fear the counterstroke that may come if they do not rein in their fury. Wolf the Gentle shows valor, though, even in this more underhanded time. We have not had cause to speak much, and that is something I deeply regret. I have high hopes for her destiny, as I realized that her appearance in my dream may indeed mark her as the harbinger to succeed me. I have received few dreams over the course of my life, but when they come, I have learned to trust them. I have also learned to trust the instincts of my heart, which tells me that Wolf the Gentle can carry the Companion's legacy as truly as any residing in Yorvaskar, especially with the loss of Skewer. Aayla is too solitary, Vilkas too fiery, and Farkas too kind-hearted. Only Wolf the Gentle stands as a true warrior who can keep a still mind amidst these burning hearts. I will not speak to her of any of this, though. It is too much to burden another with. My hope is that she and I can keep counsel over the coming years, that I can impart the wisdom of the Harbingers. All things in time. Firstly, I will seek her assistance in the matter of the Witches of Glenmoral. It would appear that our path to the cure is not without some poetic justice for the tricksters who first cursed us. Well, well, well. Let's go. In times like these, when a person has departed, oh shoot, this clipping. One really does not want to chit chat much. Oh yes, don't forget to take that piece to Yorland. Yorland, are you fixing it with that little hammer?
You're back.
I am.
Thank you. Your shield siblings have withdrawn to the Underforge. I think they're waiting for you.
Okay. Let's go and meet the circle.